Mr. President, in a few minutes, we're going to be voting on the President Trump's nomination of Mr. Kurt Engelhardt to be a judge for the United States Court of Appeals for the Fifth Circuit. And I can't think of a nominee who is more deserving and more qualified for this job. Judge Engelhardt is the Chief Judge of the United States District Court for the Eastern District of Louisiana. He has been on the federal district court bench, for 17 years. If you add up all of the cases that he has actually tried to verdict or to judgment, I think it's somewhere in the neighborhood of 75 to 100. That's on top of hundreds, undoubtedly thousands of motions that that he has heard. He's eminently qualified. But rather than reciting his resume to you, Mr. President, I just want to share with you a personal experience that I had in Judge Engelhardt's court. A number of years ago, the city of New Orleans sued a major Wall Street investment bank in a dispute over a $171 million bond issue. The bonds were called, are called pension obligation bonds, and it's an extraordinarily complex transaction. I was called as a witness because at that point in my life, I was the state treasurer of Louisiana and chairman of the state bond commission, and we had jurisdiction over the bonds when they were issued. I wasn't exactly sure whether I was a fact witness or an expert witness, and the lawyers fought over that for a while. But my point is, I was on the stand for maybe 5 hours, 6 hours, and I got to observe a little bit about the case and about Judge Engelhardt. The plaintiff's counsel, representing the city of New Orleans and the firefighters' pension system, a handful of the finest lawyers in the state of Louisiana, indeed, I would say, in the country. Representing the Wall Street Investment Bank was a partner and a number of associates from a major Wall Street law firm. In addition to their lawyers, there were dozens of clerks and associates and paralegals. It looked like Bourbon Street on Saturday night. There were so many people. And I remember thinking how many thousands and thousands and thousands of hours these lawyers and paralegals and clerks had spent understanding this case. And you could tell very quickly that both sides, both sets of lawyers, knew this case backwards and forwards. They'd almost memorized the depositions. It was, as a lawyer, it was fun for me to watch. They were going at it hammer and tong. I mean, they could recite chapter and verse from the legal briefs, from the law books, from the depositions. But there was one person, Mr. President, in that courtroom among all of these accomplished professionals who knew more about the case than anybody else, and that was the presiding judge, Kurt Engelhardt. He had total command of the subject matter. Not easy. This was a very, very, very complex municipal securities offering. He had total command of the courtroom, both sets of lawyers being aggressive, accomplished litigators, tested him quite often. That's what good lawyers do. They'll push the envelope. He maintained firm control without ever raising his voice. And I got to watch him in operation for 5 or 6 hours, Mr. President. I'd never been in his courtroom before. But after watching Judge Engelhardt in operation, I understood why just about every lawyer in Louisiana who files a lawsuit in the United States District Court for the Eastern District of Louisiana hopes that he or she gets Judge Engelhardt for the judge, because he is that good. The only group of lawyers I know that hope they don't get Judge Engelhardt for a judge in the United States District Court for the Eastern District of Louisiana are those that are unprepared or don't know their case, because he's not going to tolerate the court's time being wasted. For that reason, Mr. President, I am proud to stand here today along with my colleague, the senior senator from Louisiana, Senator Bill Cassidy, and recommend categorically and unequivocally, unconditionally, to my colleagues the nomination of Judge Kurt Engelhardt to be a member of the United States Court of Appeals for the Fifth Circuit. He will serve us proudly and well.